Hey, this is Zach from Fish Talk Magazine. I'm here today to show you how to rig and run a trot line from a fishing kayak for blue crabs. I'm using the native watercraft Slayer Propel 13 with its unique pedal drive. As a hands-free kayak, it is virtually a must when it comes to kayak trot line. Let's go over my basic boat setup. I've used my Boondocks landing gear. It's an aftermarket feature for this boat. It's got some unique track mounting, which I found to be perfect for building my custom stick. I went to the hardware store down the street, got this PVC reinforced with a wooden dowel for maximum strength. I've got a flap here on my stick to keep the snoods from wrapping around and getting caught up as I'm trot lining. I've got my crab basket preloaded with floats, anchor, and chain for each end of the trot line. I've got my tongs in my measuring stick, as well as a rag towel to keep wet, to keep the crabs nice and alive while I'm out there trot lining. I've got my wire crab net cut down to half length. I brought along a light tackle fishing rod. And in this 3 gallon bucket I keep on the bow, I have a 600 foot pre-rigged trot line.
Throw your chicken necks out in a bucket of water. Cut each piece into sections 1 inch or less.
Now bait your line by putting each piece of chicken in the snood and pulling the bungee tight.
As you load your bucket, carefully lay your line on top of itself to avoid any snags when deploying the line later.
For a 600 foot trot line, it should take you about 30 to 45 minutes. Whew, done. Cut any excess chicken necks into your 1 inch sections, take them with you to rebait on the water or freeze them for next time.
All right, it's time to trot line. So once you've reached your destination and ready to deploy your line, you'll grab the end of your trot line using brass clips. Here I'm clipping mine to about 2 feet of chain. That'll keep the line flat down on the bottom. That is connected to a large float. You need a very large size float. You're gonna wanna have your DNR ID written on that. Make sure you check your local regulations for changes in any crabbing regulations in your area. All right, we drop our float and drop our chain. I put my trot line basket in the stern of the boat. And as I pedal and start to move forward, I'm picking a spot on my horizon. And I'm gonna keep my line as straight as possible while holding my line vertically as high as I possibly can. If you get a tangle, you're gonna wanna shake it out. You can go as fast as you want, as long as you're keeping a straight line and avoiding any tangles. Every so often, you wanna give it a little tug just to make sure your anchor is caught and your trot line is very taut throughout. As you get to the end of your line, you want to make sure you're keeping an eye on how much is left. Good idea to take that end clip, clip it off to something in your kayak in case you miss it. You don't want to have to run it down to the other end, have to come back and pick up the line. All right, mine was clipped off. Now I grab my other end, my anchor chain. As it sort of swings me around, it's going to put me in a position I'm going to sort of back up, tighten my line out as I deploy my other end of my anchor line. I pedal backwards and reverse till my line gets nice and tight, keeping it in my straight line, drop an anchor. Now my 600 foot trot line has been deployed for my kayak. You can paddle down to the other end, start grabbing immediately. So I still have my 3 gallon bucket that I had my trot line in. I'm gonna use this as my calling bucket. I'm gonna put this in the bow of the boat to drop in any crabs I catch on my run and pull them out and measure before I put them in my bushel basket. All right, once you approach your line, you wanna grab your net. You're gonna reach down and grab your line and flip it up onto your stick. Now you're ready to trot line. Once you hit your chain, you're ready for those snoods to start popping up. You're gonna wanna dip your net just below. Go on and scoop those crabs up. Nice. And a nice muddy one, but little guy. There you go. And a nice one. off to a good start here. Sometimes you can't even unload them fast enough. Another little guy. A lot of times when you see your line sinking deeper in the water, it's a good indication you got some crabs coming up. If you find that your line is getting a little looser, it's a good idea to pick up anchor. Get a nice pedal head start. And just pull it out a little bit. Just a few feet. Get it real tight before you drop your anchor again. So if you're new to crabbing, to identify a male versus a female, the male has the Washington Monument and the female has the Washington Capitol Building. I like to let the females go. That's a nice jimmy. Nice one. That's a nice one. There we go, doubles. Once you cut your fill, it's time to pull up your line. You never know when a crab might be hanging out. Not a keeper, but you just never know. So pull your line up slow and deep bait. You'll keep an eye out for a few more crabs. I'm not gonna lie, that was a lot of fun. If you're looking to put a few crabs in your bushel basket, try trotlining from your kayak.
Don't miss another cool Fish Talk video. Click below to subscribe.